Yeah, thanks a lot. So just before it starts, just to make some explanation. So I'm actually working for the French government as an international technical expert in innovation, working here for the French Embassy and the Japan Science and Technology Agency. And I will speak on behalf of the French Counselor for Science and Technology, who asked me to be here today for this presentation. And so basically, same for me, too, the French system is quite complex, like maybe the German or the European one. What everybody needs to understand is that if we look at the ranking in terms of innovation worldwide, actually we stand quite well because the French CEA was number one, Fraunhofer Institute was number two, and JSC was number three. So we could make it maybe much simpler so that everybody can speak about concrete projects and how to work together, because I think between Europe and Japan there are still a lot of potential in terms of collaboration. Very quickly about the French program. We have a lot of programs for innovation, and a lot of money also poured in this. One very important, you probably will hear, of course it's a French name, but we call it Investment for the Future. It's a long-running, long-time process we started, and a lot of money is involved in this. So we are currently at the PAIA 3 with 5 billion, which is essentially driven to higher education and research. And so I will just, in these three topics, our main incentives for boosting the R&D efforts of companies, how we try to promote research, partnerships between academia, industry, and technology transfer, and something more specific for small and medium-sized companies. The main thing for boosting company research is what we call research tax credit, which is the most powerful tool we have in France for a very long time ago. And typically in 2013, sorry, it's not very recent, but the trend is always going up. We had 5.7 billion tax credits, so which means that 21 billion of R&D expenditures were poured into the companies. In terms of technology transfer, so here in France, we had a lot of work to do. Germany has a very powerful system, everybody knows. And in France, we had other systems, good also, but we had to focus a little bit more on this. And probably I will focus on this is, which is Carnot Institute. It's an initiative we started in 2006, so it's quite recent, and to work on a much more, I would say, focus between the contract between research and companies. And we labeled all these Carnot institutes. So in some of the Carnot institutes, we have company research institutes like CEA, LETI, or INRIA, which are quite famous laboratories worldwide. And we created this specific program to help them be more focused on the technology transfer and work with corporations. And actually CEA Tech, which is probably one of the most famous and is very active on the Japanese market, is one of the best examples we have. I will go very quickly on this. A lot of other platforms, but I don't have the time, sorry. We have also clusters all over France, which are dedicated to specific technologies or specific kind of research. And also something quite recent, we started to have a regional approach for technology transfer, so specific tools were created, so we call this SATT, Technology Transfer Acceleration Companies. And last but not least is the French Tech, which is specifically for helping venture companies. Everybody now is aware of this, thanks to a very strong presence at CES in Las Vegas. So for the last 3 years, we were the second delegation there. So currently this year, you had almost 200 French startups in the Eureka Park. But it's not a new process. We created this label again, French Tech, 3 years ago. But for a very long time, we have all the stakeholders, which are, of course, first the universities, the research institutes, university management schools, engineering schools, coding schools, and of course, on the private side, all the incubators, VCs, corporate VCs, and all the stakeholders needed for building companies. So what we just missed was the communication. We are very bad at communication in France, it's not new. And we try to make it a little bit better, thanks to this French Tech initiative. And packaging, I would say, our technical strengths, focusing on, of course, the major areas everybody is interested in, what is, of course, in security, fintech, clean tech, and trying to promote the French regions in which you have this long-standing research and innovation tradition. And finally, more recently, again, we started to plug ourselves in the worldwide innovation ecosystems, and we opened in the last 2 years 22 hubs, which are local. So typically, I opened the French Tech Hub here in Tokyo in October 2015, one of the very first in the world, actually, after San Francisco and New York and Tel Aviv, to be close to the local ecosystem, okay, to act as a bridge between the Japanese stakeholders and the French one. Thank you very much.